पुत्र विद्याविराजत करवारी जाता अपार कारुण्य सुदाम्बुराशिन श्री शारदाम्बा प्रणतोस्मि नित्यम विद बेनेडिक्शन टू जगन्माता शारदा परमेश्वरी दैट रिपोजिटरी ऑफ ऑल दैट इज कल्चर नॉलेज ट्रेडिशन विजडम आर्ट लर्निंग फाइन आर्ट आई बो टू हर एस ए कमेंस माय एड्रेस टुडे इट गिव्स मी ग्रेट प्लेजर टू वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस प्रेजेंट एंड सॉलम फंक्शन ऑर्गनाइज दिस ईवनिंग टू रिमेंबर द वेनरेबल डॉक्टर above all a fine human being and a physician with a magical healing touch Dr. K.S. Varadachari the more we remember him the more it sinks into us that the likes of Dr. Varadachari are no more with us he redefined what a personal physician ought to be he merged his identity with that of his patients dissolved it and became part of the patients themselves. He redefined what good medical practices were are during his living times. Today, our symbolic dysfunction may appear to be, we pay homage to him, our regard and reverence for this venerable doctor, that affable doctor, that lovable doctor, who redefined so many things for this institution of ours. Dr. Varadachari realized his worth too early in his life. He was the professor of medicine at the GS Medical College. He was the honorary medical consultant of the GT Hospital for 30 long years. He was the senior medical consultant at the Induja Hospital for 15 long years. He was the chairman of the Association of Physicians of India. He was also a certain chairman of the Cardiology Society of India. He was the vice chairman of the Hypertension Society of India. The APA honored him for his lifetime contribution as one of the outstanding teachers in medicine. He made significant contributions to the various standard textbooks in medicines that came from APA. In fact, he not only contributed to several articles as part of the book, he was also the subject editor and also chapter editor for various chapters that featured in the standard textbook of APA, which today is a Bible for students pursuing medicine the country over. His interest extended far beyond that, not just beyond the medical practice. He was deeply committed to fine arts that he came to this institution, and in the year 1989-90, he became a member of the managing council of our society, of our Sabha, till he breathed his last in the year 2008. It is equally so that in the year 1999-2000, he became a trustee of this institution. He was also the founder trustee of Nirmaya Healthcare Foundation that catered to the healthcare needs of slum children in this city. He was an active member, trustee of SOSWA, the charitable institution that networked all across the globe, particularly to the Western world, and ensured that medical equipments and instruments are sourced from those countries, brought gratis into this country, and redistributed to charitable hospitals all over the country. His interest in religion took him to the Vedanta Deshika Sampradaya Prachar Sabha, of which he was the president, till death separated him from all of us. This is the greatness of the man who gave and devoted all his life not just for the cause of healthcare, but he redefined his passion for community healthcare. The founders of this institution of ours were indeed visionaries. They spoke, they acted, and they implemented things far ahead of their generation. With no money in their wallet, in fact they had no wallet at all, they dreamt of a sabha, of an auditorium, which is not just the biggest in Bombay, not even in India, not even in Asia. In those days they dreamt of an auditorium which is the largest to the east of Suez Canal, cutting across Egypt into Africa. And in 3 years' time, they gave expression to that dream of theirs and gave us this majestic auditorium. If today we breathe culture, if we breathe community healthcare, it's thanks to the vision of the founders of this institution. Over the years, this has become a center of happening in this part of the country, and more importantly, on national affairs of the country. The founders of this institution were also pragmatic. The founders gave unto this institution a very unique combination, a combination of fine arts and healthcare. Nowhere in the world do you have a cocktail of healthcare and fine arts. Except some small institutions in Germany, you can never see a holistic combination of healthcare and fine arts. There are strong reasons behind such a combination that is evolved by them. A healthy mind in a healthy body. Unless the mind is free from vices, diseases, and is free and calm, no one can appreciate the nuances of music. And that they, therefore, were able to appreciate that health is integral to appreciation of fine arts. And thus came the combination, and the medical center was born in the year 1974. When they created this institution, they redefined culture. Culture is not a static pool, my dear friends. It's a dynamic evaluation which grows with time. The word culture itself is derived from the Latin word color. Color means to cultivate, to adore. Culture, therefore, is cultivation of the mind for love of ideals. And culture, basically, is the identity of a nation. It is the greatest virasat of a nation, the property of a nation. And that brings out the quality of a nation itself. And there can be no culture without a conscience. And if Dr. V. Subramaniam, the president of this institution for 27 long years, is credited with this holistic combination, it is singularly the efforts of Dr. Bardachari who gave expression to this intention of Dr. V. Subramaniam in creating the community healthcare center. Over the years, the healthcare center of the Sabha, we started in the year 1954, has grown. This year we are celebrating the 40th year of its useful existence in this part of the megapolis. The Kansai Neurolac Eye Care Center, which was again started with the guidance, assistance and support of Dr. Bardachari, has grown over time. Today it has a patient load, outpatient load of 30,000 per annum, and a minimum of around 750 surgeries are performed annually on the eye, basically cataract, to begin with. It was again under his inspiration that we started the dialysis center as a gift of this Sabha to this city in the Diamond Jubilee year of the institution in the year 2002. We have minimum 6,000 dialysis procedures which are conducted annually from the dialysis center of Sabha, glimpses of which were made available to you through the documentary. In the general medicine department of this institution, which caters to physiotherapy, to homeopathy, to pathology, to the lifestyle management diseases, more predominantly diabetes, we have a patient outload of 30,000 again. What is interesting about the eye care center and the dialysis center and the general medicine center, that this is one of the cheapest institutions all across the country, and it caters predominantly to the lower and vulnerable sections of the society, the poor and the needy, who throng this institution, making it possible for them to have affordable medicine at a cost which is reasonable, at a time span which guarantees them longevity. This is the greatness of the man who conceived this institution. He was the chief of the medical services for 21 long years till death separated him from that institution of ours. And during these 21 years, he contributed significantly to the cause of community healthcare with great precision, devotion and determination. What to speak of Dr. Bardachari as a person? He gave everything that he had to his patients. I think he left nothing for himself. As the call came from the master for the end journey to begin, what was left over was the baggage of memories of this great son of this city and the legacy that he had. Even that he left behind for posterity to experience, absorb, understand and assimilate. In the tomb of Westminster Abbey of Christopher Chapman, this is what is written. What I gave, I have. What I spent, I had. What I left, I lost by not giving. Bardachari singularly is one person whom I have experienced during my lifetime who lost nothing because he gave everything unto this world. Valluvan says in his Thirukkural, Pirappokkum ella uyirkkum சிறப்போவா செய்தொழின் வெற்றுமையான். All of us are born equal. I don't think God has created anyone superior to other. If there are distinctions between men and men, men and women and women and women, it is essentially based on their accomplishments. And by those standards of evaluation, Dr. Varadachari was indeed accomplished. By the sheer dint of performance and the work that he did for community healthcare in this country. Balloon again says, despite all the wealth that you can have, the only wealth that a person needs to have is the wealth of enthusiasm. And if that enthusiasm you don't have, there is no sense for all the other enthusiasm that you have. And Dr. Varadachari confounded all of us, even at their growing age, there was the enthusiasm of a person whose reservoir was always full, of a childlike innocent candor that was there, which was difficult to experience in anyone. A person who was game for even the toughest of work, notwithstanding the age that stood as a barrier for most of us at that age level that he was in. If today this institution is sustained and is moving forward with various activities in healthcare, it is thanks to that enthusiasm that he reflected during his living times as this institution came under his stewardship. Busts and tombs and statues are but an expression of the love and affection that people have got for a person who has departed. I think the contribution of the person is more pronounced, more known than during his later time, because it is generally believed that during a lifetime, a person can influence a particular conduct amongst people. So how will we receive a person beyond his living times is what will determine truly and genuinely the contribution of that person. Today we remember him, however symbolic as I said at the beginning, by having a bust of Dr. Varadachari. The bust will get relocated to the front foyer of the medical center. Countless number of patients who throng the medical center will draw inspiration from the life and times of this great doctor. More importantly, it's our belief that the great doctor shall bless each one of them for quick relief and immediate recovery so that they can go back from the medical center with the speed with which they come into the medical center. For little men who suffer an abortion of their counterfeit to glory, they require statues and busts. But to those great men who become deathless institutions as they move away from the physical plane to the world beyond, it is their thoughts, it is their actions which become the warp and woof of the thought and the dreams of the generation that succeeds. They carve a niche for themselves in the rocky temple of reverential gratitude. And to that tribe belongs Dr. Varadachari. May the good Lord, wherever he is ensconced, bless us all so that we continue to be healthy. And God forbid, if ailments come to us which are a natural process of osmosis of life, that this center that he had created with so much love and affection will continue to address and alleviate the sufferings of the poor, the vulnerable sections of the society. May the good Lord shed his grace on all of us so that we can draw a leaf from the life of nobility of Dr. Varadachari and make our own lives sublime. Thank you and God bless us all.